Hyrum Reservoir, got the llama pack, got the nephews this time. We thought we'd come up here, bring them up here, and let them land fat trout. So, again, go ahead and hit the like, hit the subscribe. Let us know what you guys are looking for. Thanks. Stinky Balls bait. Bought this online, said it's gonna catch me some trophy trout, want to try it. Doesn't float, so my options today are nightcrawler bobber, line it like a salmon egg, or marshmallow with this. We're gonna start out with marshmallow with the Stinky Balls. I'll let you know how this happens. So I'm trying a couple of new things today, guys. I've got both Lose Out, the Lose Custom XP, the Lose American Hero. The Custom XP is the one with the marshmallow and the Stinky Balls bait. That one's already been hit once. I have the bells on, just wanted to test them out, see if they're a little bit earlier strike indicator besides it taking my pole into the water. Right one, American Hero, I'm running Power Bait. Right now, garlic on there, the light green one. When we were up here 2 weeks ago, we crushed it with the chartreuse. My one nephew is running chartreuse and cheese power bait on his poles. No strike indicators there, so we'll see how it's going right now. As I was dealing with my nephew's one pole, I did get the strike indicator bell ring, then they dropped it. If I would have been by the pole, I think I would have hooked him up, but that was with the Stinky Balls and marshmallows. So far, good results. Continue to let you know. First trout on. It's been a while. He's a little beefy, I think. Makes it nice. Nothing like what we got last couple of times we were here, but he's still a decent little trout. There we go, guys. More food for the smoker. All right, guys. Fish on, nephew Golden has it. We're gonna head over with the net. Watch him fight and wrestle with this thing. So here we go. Nephew Golden, need to reel it in. It's got some chunk to it. Pull up on it. There you go. Now reel. There we go. Where is he? Come on. Come up to the surface. Oh, he's back. Oh, bream. Dude, he's natural. Woo! Look at that bad boy. Got him. Garrett. Yeah. He's on now. He better be. Yep, there you go. Reel him in. You gotta reel down and then pull up. There you go. Reel down, pull up, and then. Dude, he. Here. Hold on. Hold on. Okay. That's yours?
Oh my god, that freaking hurt my arm so bad.
Look at that, guys. Another one. Nephew Garrett on that one. Hey guys, got one. He's a little beefy. Hopefully he's the same size as Golden's and Garrett's. Careful. Nice one. There we go. Golden with the assist. Got a little beat up head. A little deformity in his head there. So, that's unique. So as you can see right there, we got a weird looking head on this guy. Don't know what it is. He is a planter. So it could be something from the hatchery. There's his tail fin cut. That's a little abnormal, so. Hopefully it's not a whirling disease or anything else like that. I don't think it is because there's no abnormal spine on him, but he is a very large, pretty guy. So, but he's getting filleted up and smoked. Drag. Run, dude, run. My reel's all wrapped up. Shoot. I've even got loose. So.
Oh yeah, big fish.
Almost.
Oh, oh yeah, here, here, here. Since you're in the water, it's close to me.
Thank you. Sorry guys, didn't even talk through that one. There was a medical emergency, fellow fisherman. Fell, broke his ankle, son came over to give us some perch. Talking to him, I looked down and my pole's going into the water. So, tried to rescue my pole, got line wrapped up in it. So. Hey guys, got another one. Just hooked him up, took my pole again. He's not as big as the others. Giving up a little fight. Trying to get into the rocks here. Oh! He snapped off! My hook and everything, man. I gotta loosen up the drag, I think. Guys, I failed you on that one. All right, guys. Garrett's got one. He's hefty. Had his whole pole bent. Okay, go down. And then you pull back up. And then you reel down and pull back up. There you go. Bring him here, Garrett. Over here. There we go. Got another one. Yep. Thought I'd loosen my drag up enough for this guy. Another one just jumped. I'm hoping it's the one that got off last week. Yeah, he snapped my 10-pound test, my 10-pound line. This is a nice size one, look at that. Oh yeah. You got him? Get in there firm. Firm. There you go. Sorry. Dude, that's a 5-pounder. All right, guys. I think this makes up for the one that broke my line this week and last week. He is fat. Alright guys, we're 7 fish on the stringer, 3 perch, poles are still in the water. That last trout was my personal best trout at almost 24 inches and over 5 pounds. It's a beast. I'm excited. Haven't caught one that big before. Looking forward to smoking it. Looking forward to showing you guys that one. If you like what you've seen so far, hit the like and hit the subscribe. And comment below on what your personal best trout is. Garrett with another one. Hold on, Garrett. Right there. Running. There you go. There we go. He's pretty. There we go, guys. Pretty little stalker, little planter trout here. There you go, guys. Pretty little stalker. Hey, guys. So, wrapping it up here. You got to see my nephews catch some fish. You got to see me catch some fish. Keli, this is payback for the Price River where he destroyed me. But he didn't get anything. Give him some props though in the comment section. He needs the rah rah. But stay tuned. You guys like this? Go ahead and hit the like and the subscribe button. And look forward to bringing you something next week. Guys, as promised, we're going to start the cook and smoke. Tonight, we're going to be focusing on the brine. So I filleted the trout. That's all set out and done. I want to focus on the brine. Now my brine is a little bit different than most people's. It's more of a teriyaki brine on this one. All the sauce, all all the salt that you use in the brine is in the soy sauce more than anything else. So what I use, 1/3 cup brown sugar. Here, there's a seasoning provider here locally called Spadel Ranch. They've got a fish seasoning. I like to use this. It gives a little bit of a dill, flavor there. The Utah just came out in me. A little bit of the dill flavor there. It helps out, gives it a little punch for you too. So I like to do a tablespoon of that. Then, 2 cups of soy sauce. There, and then I go with 1 cup of warm water. Helps dissolve the brown sugar and the salt. Then we take the whisk and we whisk it, get it all going good before it's all dissolved. This is for 3 pounds. This should cover about 3 pounds of fillets. This batch here. So if you've got more, you want to double it, it gives you 6. You want it to cover your trout in what they do. So here's where I like to place my trout. I like to start out putting a little bit on the bottom so we have something for them to soak in. Skin on, fillet, place it in there. Another skin on fillet, placed in. And I just get them in here. Crosshatch it. Because the ones on the bottom have already covered because of the weight. And I like to add that. Put a little bit more in here to cover that batch. We'll go ahead and add a little bit more water. We'll then take this brine. We'll brine these for 8 hours. I'll see you tomorrow when I take this out of the brine, pat it down, and we'll get it going on the smoke. Hey guys, next day we're gonna go ahead and get the smoke going. I'll show you the fish here in a second with the prep. What I wanted to let you know is this is what I am doing. I actually have a Traeger. I don't have a Traeger. Keli has the Traeger. What I use for trout, it's trout only, is I have the Brinkman smoker grill. It's the little bullet smoker that I like to use. I use wood chips, what I like is I'm using mesquite, Western premium products, wood chips, and then my little hack that I like to use with this briefing, because it gets really hot in there with the lump charcoal, is I like to take a small little envelope, right, fill the packet up completely with wood chips until I can barely seal it. What this allows me to do is I have five of them, and I put one packet in every 30 minutes. So that's going to allow me to, in turn, keep track of my burn time. So 2.5 hours is usually what I smoke my trout at, and when it's done, it's still a little moist, but dry enough for the smoke, and you can get that great flavor in there. Next step is I'm going to show you guys the trout, pat it dry, and we're going to get it going. But before I do any of that, I got to get the smokestack going for the lump charcoal and get that in there, because it's going to take me really, it's going to be real quick to get the trout going. I got some of the trout out. I got it on the table, placed on a paper towel, and then I'm going to dry that here. As you guys can see, it's all dried up, ready for the smoke. So I'm going to pat this dry, I'll arrange it on the racks, and then as you'll see, I'll place the racks in, show you what I got going on, and then we'll begin that smoke. Nice and dry. Leave it in, I don't know. But either way, learning lesson today was don't smoke with lump charcoal bare feet. I forgot to wear my sandals, so stepped on a coal that had fallen outside of the Brinkman, and I think I got a second degree burn on the foot. So the things I do for YouTube, the things I do for this is shocking. It makes my wife laugh. The Llama Queen was inside cackling with glee that this happened, but lesson of the day, wear shoes, sandals, whatever, if you're smoking with charcoal. Now, if you guys like the Catch a Smoke this week, go ahead and like, subscribe, let me know anything, feedback, opinions, all that fun stuff. I'm here doing this for fun and for you guys. Enjoying life. You know.